Coffee for takeaway, please. Send some guys to Mega. Mega. One. Oh, Mr. Captain! Oh, Captain Veto! Ah, son bambino è Veto, you eat, Baba.
Connected, eh?
this is your area?
Yeah.
So why are you running out of your area?
Yours is that side. Sheldon, stay connected.
Come, Sammy, come, Sammy.
Come, Ref.
Okay, nice, Cortez. Sammy, down.
Sigle, 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 get away there. Sammy, come. Sigle, get the ball. Sigle, get the ball here. Come on. Yeah. Sammy, Sammy. Yes. Don't foul him, don't foul him. Well done. Yes, yes. Well done. Second ball. Yes.
Quickly, behind him. We are 2 minutes from the start of the ABC game tonight. I have to turn takes on Crystal Palace. It's a very, very windy evening here at Camden. And looking forward to a good football.
Tighter. Yes, Sammy.
With the players in the starting lineup of the teams tonight. Starting with Ajax, Kane,
yes, play the ball, use the ball, use the ball.
Ronaldo,
yes.
Lena.
Right
left. JD, Adam. Left back. Center back. Dean, Solomon. Azola, Chabo. And in the middle of the park, we have Sonoa.
Don't come to him, man.
Courtney Williams,
Lean
Derby,
easy like that, please.
And the forwards are Gilly France,
one, two.
Godfrey Persson, and Morule Pachabil. And on the bench for Ajax Cape Town is Leo Tetani, Colin Ryan, Juanito Menyo, Luther Jacobs, Riyad Kopstad, and Luke First, and that those are the starting players and the substitution for Ajax Cape Town. And we're looking on the opposition for tonight, Crystal Palace, all the way from Manenberg. In goals, they got Christopher Titus, and they got Sheldon Barrett, and their jersey number 5 is Lunga Nozela, Sihle Devu. Mazagwandi Le Peterson, Tando Zwele, Viani Zolokoso, Theo Tutu, Taylor Paru, Samkelo Lunko, Bushepo. On the bench for Crystal Palace is Anele Jalivan, Alzid Poso, Lungi Le Mayekiso, Rafik Mayegiso, Rafik Isaacs, Ati Makale, Kyle Wordy, Lyle van der Heer. So the match is on, it's 5 minutes on, no goals. It's 0-0 here at Pedro Itigamva. Ajax in their traditional red and white colors, and Crystal Palace blue shirts, blue socks, and blue shorts.
Get up! Quicker!
At the moment, I think both teams are waving themselves up. Offside. From the left side with their left wing, jersey number 7 was caught offside there. Some get on those goals. We're going to restart the game from Renato Lena, goalkeeper for Ajax Cape Town. Number 1.
Look around you. Come this way.
Well, Ajax Cape Town is making history today because the ABC team has an average age of 17. And it's quite a very interesting lineup. If you look at the players that have come through the development at 17, they're able to compete with players mostly over 23 from the ABC team of Crystal Palace. But the team seems to be evenly matched, and it's very, very competitive right there in the middle of the park. What we've noticed about the two teams is they've chosen a calm approach. And I guess they're busy caging each other and sensing. It's been very difficult at the moment. Having cut short. Nice Cape Town are forced to play the ball backwards into their goalkeeper. Again, like I mentioned earlier on, the interpassing at the back has been broken by a very pressing Crystal Palace team, with no team not able to carry or have more than 3 passes. But it's been a great evening. The game has a lot of potential. And it looks like the opportunities are far in between at the moment. Captain for Ajax today. Jersey number 9. Dead in front. Jersey number 8. Captain today. A long ball from the goalkeeper. Finally kicked it all the way to the opposite goalkeeper.
Hey, Blake! Shapers!
Throw it immediately to his center back. A long searching ball. Knocked down header from Crystal Palace. Another free kick given away by the Ajax midfield. Number 10, Godfrey Preston. So far, we're not seems to be getting any clear cut scoring chances or any clear movement. The teams are both cutting from each other. Pick back on their half, and the game being played mostly in the Ajax half.
Don't foul him! Pushing it there. Well done, Sammy, you got it. Yes! Strong, Tando! Come! Yes!
Another slow build-up from Ajax Cape Town from the back. A long diagonal ball to the left reaches the Ajax left back. Possession being given away again. The Crystal Palace on the ball, they're coming up in the right wing. We're expecting a cross from this one. Brilliant cross, nicely cleared by the Ajax defense. That was the decent move in the first half. It's been quite a quiet first half with less opportunities at the moment. And it's both teams able to cancel each other's out. I guess it's still early days in the game. I mean, with only it's almost 10 minutes into the first half, and ball kicked way off the park by the Ajax defenders. And we're all going in for another throw. It's an interesting cold evening, you know, for all of those who came to watch the game at Tikampa. Obviously, a little bit of an action will make a difference, you know, for the fans coming in to watch this particular game. Again, another ball being given away. A throw in for Crystal Palace. It's a very difficult, you know, when it's a stop-start game, basically. Both teams cancelling each other's out. A long throw for the Ajax left back. Nice trap in from the Ajax number 9. With a good movement and good interpassing between the two Ajax strikers. Another interception from the Crystal Palace defence. Well, it seems to be the story of the night. Tonight. You know, where both teams are not able to hold on to the ball for more than 3 touches. But very interesting moves from the Ajax strikers earlier on, but the ball obviously never reached the 18 area of the opposition. With a good movement from Dylan French. Dylan French is a very tall fella, so he's able to muscle and bustle out up front there with Crystal Palace defenders. Free kick given to Ajax. That was an infringement from Crystal Palace number 9, Mukwe. He's quite a tall figure, a very energetic number 9. Slow build-ups again from Ajax Cape Town. A true ball looking for Dylan French with a very interception from Dylan French. A great interception. He lost the ball again. There's Ajax with the attack. 1-2 between Dylan French. That also been cut again. Clever movement from Sonwabile. That should be a free kick given by the referee, but he waved. Play on. Long ball from Crystal Palace. Off the park again. You know, it doesn't take long for the players to be able to lose their momentum and give the ball away. But it was a great pass from Sonwabile to try to get it in front. Almost a breakthrough pass. Did in front, battling it out with his defense. Nice interception from Lunga Ngozela, center defender for Crystal Palace. A long throw from Ajax Cape Town right back, JD Adams. Good interception from Ajax defense. We see the Ajax number 10 now, right to find the right wing. Just number 7, Courtney Williams. We're expecting a cross from him. Intercepted by the Crystal Palace left back. The ball go back on play. Long ball from Crystal Palace, which gets a very relaxed centre back at Ajax Cape Town in the likes of Dean Solomon. An interpass between Ajax Cape Town players trying to get some breakthrough. Sonwabile touches the ball very well. 1-2, fighting in the middle of the park. Again, an interception from Crystal Palace. It seems to be the story of the day tonight. The passes are not going through from both teams. It is always a ball intercepted, you know, after 2 touches. Another throw in for Ajax Cape Town with what was a promising move from Crystal Palace. Also broken and been broken down by the Ajax defense. A great leap from the Ajax number 9, Dylan France. But the ball went through the Crystal Palace keeper. Long clearance from him that surpassed a lot of players. The ball goes all the way back to the Ajax goalkeeper, who has cleared a long ball, well clapped and put down by the Ajax captain. But the ball got back to the opposition. Clean. Fredericks is the Ajax captain tonight. He's playing in the second striker role. And you could see they're trying to revolve the play around him. And it's been quite a very difficult evening to create any chances of note. Small build-ups again from Ajax Cape Town. I think the ball was intended for the Ajax number 7, but the Ajax right back intercepted that ball, JD Adams. Intercepted the ball that was played from the back to Courtney Williams, by Dean Solomon. back into the action. Once again, Crystal Palace does do very well to check down and cut all the movements and all the attempts from Ajax Cape Town. The ball well defended by Ajax Cape Town, a free kick given by the referee. Infringement from the Crystal Palace players. We're going to start again from Ajax Cape Town, a slow build up from goalkeeper Ronaldo Lennon. Playing it with defenders. Going across to Dean Solomons, who pulls it back to Ronaldo Lennon. Long diagonal pass to the Ajax left back, who mistrapped the ball all the way out. That was Mohamed Boum, who will keep control of the ball. A long throw from Crystal Palace, trying to find the number 10 right wing of Crystal Palace, a free kick from an infringement. Coming in from Azola Ntsabo, who's defending from the left side and the left back of Ajax Cape Town. A free kick in the 18 area for Crystal Palace. This might look a very dangerous free kick, especially if a quality delivery has been played on. From the existing free kick, it was cleared by the Ajax defense. The first corner of the game from Crystal Palace. Taking on by jersey number 17, Theo Dudu. Let's see how the Ajax boys will deal with this corner kick. Well taken free kick. Ronaldo comes up, claims the ball. Delivery throw right into the on-running captain. And Clint Fredericks was second to the ball. It was intercepted by the Crystal Palace defense. A throw-in for Ajax Cape Town. That will be taken by Azola Ntsabo. Long throw-in from Azola. Find the Ajax player Jonito Nimenyon, a long cross from Ajax straight into the Crystal Palace keeper. Long throw again, another ball goes all the way out from the long throw from the goalkeeper, trying to get his left back. Nicely trapped in by the Ajax number 9. Again, a battle in the middle of the park with the interception 1-2 from Ajax Cape Town. So Nwabile miskicked and he's trying to retrieve the ball. He does well there. So Nwabile to win the 50-50 ball. Nice cross from Ajax Cape Town in the D-line. Another interception from Crystal Palace. And they're able to get away from trouble from that particular action from Ajax Cape Town. Almost a collision between two Ajax centre-backs there. Dean Solomons and Anele Ntsabo. No communication in that regard, but they get away from that action unscathed. A very good header again from Dean Solomons, outsmarting the Crystal Palace strikers with a long ball. The Crystal Palace players trying to get a one-on-one. The action now, it's starting, it's coming thick and fast, where players are trying to create opportunity for themselves. I think the game is opening up a bit now, as you can see. It's 20 minutes into a game. Now the game is starting to become very interesting with little pockets of chances opening up. I think the referee has not taken note. Ronaldo Lennon has been injured after clearing the ball from the back, and he's set it down, and the physio is going to attend to him.
Dando, you can't have that three guys, eh? Don't forget. Don't forget.
We're having a small break now, right now at the moment, with Ronaldo Lennon receiving treatment. Hopefully it's not too serious. Seems like a knee Europa, the game, it's slightly put on hold. With Ronaldo Lena seems to be in serious pain, and the possibilities of substitution, Bosi doesn't look too good. Just hope we don't have to go through a substitution at the moment, but the Ajax Cape Town reserve goalkeeper is warming up, and we will hear from the physio in a couple of seconds of whether Ronaldo Lena will be able to continue with the game. First change for Ajax Cape Town. 23 minutes into the first half, Ronaldo Lena has injured himself, and he is going to be replaced. By jersey number 16, Luther Jacobs. Luther Jacobs is coming on in the place of Ronaldo Lena. So an early four substitution for Ajax Cape Town in the 24th minute of the first half, with the scoreline between Ajax Cape Town and Crystal Palace still remains scoreless. And the first half still underway. And hopefully Ronaldo Lena will come back in action soon, but his game tonight is about finished. Just once again to remind all of you of Ajax Cape Town taking on Crystal Palace in a very cold and windy evening here at Ikamva in Pero. The score after 25 minutes is still 0-0, with minimal chances created between the two teams. Ajax with slow build up from the back, and Crystal Palace dealing well with all through passes being played by Ajax Cape Town. But there's been promising movements from the Ajax Cape Town right inside of the midfield, with a fresh shot and the goal in anger from Sonwabile. Didn't come anywhere close to the goal line, but it's an attempt for the first time in the first minute, in the 27th minute of the first half, from Sonwabile Fekane. An angry shot that went way past the Crystal Palace goal. Another long clearance from the goalkeeper from Crystal Palace, Sonwabile, the first on the ball with the header. Dylan France was the second in receiving of that ball. Another battle in the middle of the park, a free kick. Free kick given away to Crystal Palace by the referee on an unfair tackle from the Ajax Cape Town, Courtney Williams. Courtney Williams is a guy with a lot of beard. You would swear and think that he is on his 20s already, but he's only 20 years old. In actual fact, his true age is 17 years old. He is a serious looking face, the young fella. Has been around, a lot of improvement in his game, but a lot of effort showed from the Ajax players today. They seem to be very competitive tonight. if you're looking at the age difference between the players, and there's more physicality coming from the Ajax players tonight, which is quite surprising if you consider that they are the youngest in age on the field tonight. But they're able to deal with what the Crystal Palace has to offer. You know, I guess they're using advantage of being a home team. Yeah, another one of those evenings where we're not spoiled for action-packed game. It's the action is fine between anywhere close to the goals. Another long clearance from the Crystal Palace goalkeeper. Hey, all the way. Nice header coming in from Dean Solomons, you know, the centre-back for Ajax Cape Town. He's a tall boy. I guess that's why he's able to win all these 50-50 shots. Another battle in the middle of the park with Dylan Franz coming out with the ball. 1-2 passes between Dylan Franz and the Ajax number 10. It came to nothing once again. Is doing well in covering their backs. You know, if we can say anything about this game, we would say both defense of both teams are able to deal with whatever that each team, you know, has to come up with. So I think, you know, in the second half, both coaches have a lot to talk about with the players at halftime in terms of how they will be able to come up with plans of unsettling in both defenders. Another free kick won by Ajax Cape Town in the middle of the park. And the free kick, it's going to be taken by the Ajax Cape Town central defense, Mohamed Bou. A nice move from the right from Ajax Cape Town once again. Most build up from Ajax Cape Town are coming from the right hand side with JD Adams very comfortable in the ball, with Courtney Williams also very, very comfortable. Ajax Cape Town coming out loud with the ball going wide. We're expecting a cross. Low cross intercepted by Crystal Palace once again.
Be strong.
Tight marking from Ajax Cape Town. A nice movement. Our two players tackling the Crystal Palace very physical. Number 9, Muhle Bokwe, who has been everywhere up front. He's quite a mobile fella. He's well built. You know, he compliments his physique. Another long ball, long clearance. Well headed and well read ball. Courtney also played wide for Dylan French, who trapped it nicely. Put it down, played JD Williams, another back ball, another build up from Ajax Cape Town all the way to Lubberg. Nice trapping from Crystal Palace. They're putting much pressure to the Ajax players. They're forcing them to play the ball quickly and not allowing them to settle down. And Ajax on the ball again. I'm not sure what Azora was doing right there. He gave the ball away cheaply, but Ajax is able to retrieve it. Another wild shot from Crystal Palace. Hopefully that was not a rugby shot, because it went all the way to a Dane Steyn clearance right there. It's a very interesting game, but little shots at goals. If you are not here, you're not missing much. 20-30 minutes into a game. Two shots at goal from both sides, or both shots were very wide off the mark. So we haven't recorded any shot at goal. We recorded only short wide, with a lot of passes intercepted from both teams. Not more than 3 touches from both teams. Solid defensive lines from both teams as well. They're reading the games very well from defense. If you're not here today, you're not watching Ajax today, tomorrow you will have a chance to watch Ajax Cape Town going all the way to PAAL Mbekweni, where they will be taking on the PAAL Mbekweni selected teams. Kickoff is at 2 o'clock. Well, a decent pass from Ajax Cape Town. It's a brilliant movement from the right between Courtney Williams and JD Adams. A nice cross from Ajax Cape Town. Cannot believe, could you believe it? What a miss from Dylan French. Best movement of the game. That should have been 1-0 for Ajax Cape Town, without a doubt. Dylan French missing a chance. 9 meters into the goal line. A beautiful cross from Trostny Williams. Couldn't deal with it. The keeper coming out goalkeeper lost it completely. Shot from Crystal Palace. It's 1-0. 1-0 to Crystal Palace. A very bad call from Ajax goalkeeper. He made a very bad call there. He should have left it to their defenders. He came out of his line trying to deal with a looping ball from Crystal Palace. Only managed to parry the ball in front of the Crystal Palace strikers, who tapped it in the open net. It's 1-0 to Crystal Palace. Crystal Palace lead 33 minutes into the game by a goal to nil. And now we are seeing a first substitution for Crystal Palace in the first half. Another four substitution, an injury for Crystal Palace. Number six coming in the place of an injured Crystal Palace defense. So we see now a makeshift defense from Crystal Palace with the new number six coming in from Crystal Palace. So Ati Makala comes in, replaces Lunga Mozela. It's a chase for the ball right in the back between a nice cross from Courtney. Keeper coming out, collects the ball. Crystal Palace goalkeeper dealt with a very dangerous cross from Courtney Williams. Vice captain from the through ball from Sonwabile. Another battle in the middle of the park with the nice interpasses movement from Ajax Cape Town. We're expecting a cross once again. Well tackled from Crystal Palace. Keep a wave play on with what looks like a clumsy tackle from Crystal Palace midfielders. But it's 1-0 here at Ajax Cape Town, Ikamva Pero Park. So Crystal Palace leading from a mistaken judgment from the Ajax goalkeeper. Remember, an Ajax Cape Town have made an early substitution with Ronaldo Lena got injured earlier on. He was replaced by none other than Luther Jacobs. 33 minutes into the game, Luther Jacobs made an error of judgment in coming out for the ball, and he punched the ball straight into the legs of the Crystal Palace striker, who tapped in the open net, and that gave Crystal Palace a 1-0 lead. Another injury for Ajax Cape Town. They're currently playing with 10 men at the moment, with jersey number 10, Godfrey Preston, injured after a rough and hard tackle from the Crystal Palace defenders. Crystal Palace are on the attack on the left-hand side of the midfield. They won themselves a free kick, with the Ajax defender judged to have pulled down the striker. Heavy instructions from the Crystal Palace coach, Stanton Ware. We remember him. Nicely caught there from the Ajax goalkeeper. It was well fetched with a long distribution that went all. Oh, what a mistake! What a terrible mistake! That's a terrible, terrible mistake from the Crystal Palace goalkeepers, who allowed the Ajax Cape Town striker Dylan French to intercept what was an easy take from him. That's a bad judgment. Tonight it's 1-1 here at Ikamva in peril. Bartnikov errors from both goalkeepers. What was a long clearance from the Ajax goalkeeper, which looked safe coming into the hands of the Crystal Palace goalkeeper for some weird reason. He never really collected the ball, with Dylan France coming in first and notching the ball in the open net. It's amazing. We got two goals, and both goals are being scored in what is a very erratic calls from both goalkeepers. Well, that was a bad one. The Crystal Palace defender headed the Ajax striker at the back of the head, but it looks okay. He seems to be coming up on his back, on his feet, with free kicks being taken by Ajax Cape Town. 36 minutes into the game, we 1-1 now, with an Ajax Cape Town getting a very, very interesting equalizer. But you have to give credit to the Ajax strikers in chasing what was a lost cause. The lost cause was changed into a goal. That's what happened when you don't give up, I guess. And it's one of those rewards that you get as a striker if you fully focus on the game. You give your all and you try to chase everything that is on the pitch. We're back level. It's 1-1. Ajax Cape Town versus Crystal Palace. You know, couldn't believe, you know, the good old way the Ajax Cape Town is getting a throw in with what has been the Crystal Palace ball. The Crystal Palace defender delayed throwing in the ball on the field, and the referee has judged and given the ball away back to Ajax Cape Town to kickstart the game. Another long ball from quality work from the Crystal Palace centre defender, heading the ball back to his goalkeeper. Well, back into the action. In the middle of a park again. Ball going back all the way to the Ajax keeper, who clears another long ball. Hopefully Crystal Palace this time they're able to deal with it. And they did, with the Crystal Palace captain clearing the ball all the way. So now we're tackling in the middle of a park. 1-2 between... Whoa, Juanito. Great movement from him. Courtney Williams with a long cross. Straight into the Crystal Palace goalkeeper. Game is opening up a bit now. Looks very interesting now, with both teams creating chances now. I think spaces are being opened in the middle of a park. The competition is getting more easier now. 1-2 from Ajax Cape Town. Another 1-2. Shot! Ekceleni. Kwepali from Dylan France. It was a very interesting 1-2 between Dylan France and his partner right there front, with a short, long shot hit wide. It's an interesting game now this evening. It's hotting up and it's becoming interesting. I think Crystal Palace bench, the coach has sent instruction for his bench to warm up. Remember, there were two forced changes early on in this game. A bad clearance from the goalkeeper straight to Dylan France, who couldn't trap the ball. Long ball. Brilliant move from Crystal Palace centre back. Shot! What a save from the Ajax goalkeeper. Brilliant shot from the Crystal Palace striker. A save, an equally matched by the Ajax young goalkeeper. Corner kick from Crystal Palace. It was a brilliant cross from the Crystal Palace centre back, right straight into a sleeping Ajax left back, who didn't read the ball well. He was badly positioned. And we saw the Crystal Palace right wing launching into the ball, and he had a brilliant shot, well stopped and well saved by the Ajax goalkeeper. Back into the action, nice clearance, finding Dylan French, who traps the ball well. One looping ball to the right, Ajax fighting it on. Another JD Adams. Yes. Trying to play the ball through the legs of the Crystal Palace left back, Courtney Williams. Again, he's very comfortable in taking on the Crystal Palace left back, Courtney Williams, right on the right hand side of the game. And the captain of Ajax has the ball now. Play 1-2 with Courtney Williams, and hopefully we get an offside. A charge offside. I'm glad to see Luther Jacobs coming up with a fine save. That will give him a lot of confidence, you know, after the erratic judgment that he made in giving Crystal Palace a goal away earlier on in the half. And you know, it always makes a lot of difference to the goalkeeper's confidence when he makes such a great save. Again, another battle in the middle of the park. Ajax Cape Town looks a little bit more comfortable now. They're trying to find their feet, and their movement with the ball looks to be interesting at the moment. With the last final 5 minutes of the first half, should be a free kick. It has to be a free kick. A tackle from behind from the Crystal Palace defenders. We're expecting a free kick from Ajax Cape Town. I think it's going to be left swing from the left-footed Juanito. No, he's leaving it. He's leaving it for his captain. His captain.
Do it quickly.
Take the free kick. Lind Fredericks is going to take the free kick for Ajax Cape Town with a lot of Ajax and tall defenders on the box. A nice floated ball with the Ajax header. Oh, what a mess. It should have been 2-1. Should have been 2-1. Dean Solomon's coming all the way from the back. Looping header. Missed the target. Still 1-1 here in Peru. Ajax Cape Town 1-1 with Crystal Palace. We're expecting 2 minutes before the break. Another clearance from Ajax Cape Town. JD Adams has been doing well tonight. Like I said earlier on, the Ajax Cape Town youngsters, they're really giving their best here tonight, and they're competing very well. But Crystal Palace are giving a nice cross from Crystal Palace. Whoa, nice clearance again from Dean Adams. And Ajax Cape Town is now have counter attack from Ajax Cape Town. Ajax Cape Town, Clint Fredericks on the ball. Tackle from deep behind. Azola with a clearance. Throwing from Ajax Cape Town. It looks like we're going to go into the break. Looks like it will stay 1-1. It's been a very interesting 43 minutes from both teams competing, being able to read each other's game very well. But Crystal Palace comes quickly on the white. Well done. Nice timing from Azola Red, left back. Giving the ball to Sonwabile. Sonwabile finding his Ajax left wing, the captain, Clint Fredericks, has the ball. He is taking on one-on-one Crystal Palace defender. Throw in.
Pick up again.
For Ajax Cape Town. Well read from the Crystal Palace defense. Ajax Cape Town again. I'm going to get a throw in. Right in the edge of the Crystal Palace box. A long throw from Azola, I guess. He's trying to find a long throw to Fredericks. Fredericks trapped the ball down in the box. Nicely tackled by Crystal Palace, but Ajax Cape Town recoup the ball. They have the ball. Again, another interception from Crystal Palace. What do they do with the ball? Well-timed tackle from Azola at left back from Ajax Cape Town. One minute into the game and 1 minute before the halftime from Ajax Cape Town. Crystal Palace have carried themselves well tonight, and I have to give credit to the team. Well-behaved, well-mannered team. You know, they're taking on their chances. JD Adams was taken to cleaners there by a very skillful Crystal Palace left wing, and he seems to have a number on JD Adams, and he's giving away a free kick in a very dangerous position. Let's see if Crystal Palace are going to take an advantage of this free kick. Just a minute into injury time of the first half. I think this will be the last action for the first half for Crystal Palace. What do they do with it? Nicely. Whoa. It's a wasted floated ball that went all the way over the bar. It remained 1-1. A very interesting first half, with the game started very slowly, with action very few in between, and the game improved in the latter part of the first half, and we started seeing teams attacking each other well, and now it's 1-1, and with referee's optional time of the end, a long clearance from the Ajax keeper Jacobs with the cross from Ajax, header from Dylan Franch, missed! Can you believe it? He missed! He was at the center circle in a penalty spot with the well-floated free kick from the Ajax Cape Town left wing. Brilliant move from Ajax Cape Town. You would expect a top-class number 9 like Dylan Franch to be able to make contact with the ball. It should have been 2-1 to Ajax Cape Town. No, nice 1 to Ajax from Ajax Cape Town. A shot! Over the bar. He forgot his shooting boots. That's Juanito Williams. He forgot his shooting boots. Well, it's still 1-1. We're seeing a lot of chances now from Ajax Cape Town, you know, with the well-worked movement between the Ajax strikers, but it's still 1-1. It should have been probably 3-2 right now, or 4-3, with the chances coming on later in the first half, but becoming a very interesting game in a very cold evening here in Peru. A long clearance from Crystal Palace. We could hear the referee's whistle any time from now to blow for half time. In actual, he gives a free kick away to Crystal Palace. Nicely played ball from Crystal Palace from the back, trying to build the game. Long clearance from the Crystal Palace long back. I think it will be dealt with by the Crystal Palace strikers. They have the ball in the middle of the park. Nice, interesting 1-2 taken away by Juanito Adams. 1-2 playing with Courtney Williams with Dylan Franz. Long pass in the middle of the park. Half time. It is half time here at Ikamva in Peru. Crystal Palace scored first and make it 1-0 after a mistake by the Ajax goalkeeper Jacobs. And an equalizer from Dylan Franz with another mistake from the Crystal Palace goalkeeper, which was an easy ball to collect. That was taken through in the open net by an Ajax Cape Town striker. And it's all ended 1-0 here at Peru Park. Eric Amber, it's Crystal Palace 1, Ajax Cape Town 1.
Hey, Ayan, the dice, please, mate. Come on. Play too good today. Come on.
Back live. Guys, Cape Town taking on Crystal Palace here at Tikamva. Still 1-1. Still 1-1. Beating Ajax Cape Town and Crystal Palace. Remember earlier on, we had a forced substitution from Ajax Cape Town goalkeeper Ronaldo Lena, replaced by Jacobs. And then Crystal Palace later on, they also had to make a substitution or alteration in defense, where we saw their number 17, Theo Tutu, coming off, replaced by jersey number 6, Ati Makala. And Ati Makala came straight into left back. The shape didn't change much, really, for Crystal Palace, because they still have a very formidable back four with a very impressive captain, Sheldon Barnes, leading the pack from the back with his impressive partner in Lunga Ngozela, who seems to be very, very comfortable in that back four. But not taking anything away from Dylan France, he's able to be a constant threat in the center of the park, especially when he gets quality balls falling in on his feet. Once again, Ajax Cape Town win the ball in the midfield. What a pass from Ajax Cape Town. Dylan France, shot! Over the bar. Over the bar. Interesting movement from Ajax Cape Town. Nice flowing, a very good through ball from the middle of the park with a beautiful run made by Dylan France, with the shot managing to go over the bar. Back live. Crystal Palace with a 1-2 movement in the middle of the park. Well matched by the Ajax midfield. I'm quite impressed by the work rate that has been put on by Sonwabile in the middle of the park. He's known to be a player with less work rate, but today he seems to be surprising everyone. Sonwabile Mfecane, good with his feet and very good on the ball. But tonight, work rate, he showed a lot of improvement as a player. I guess the players are maturing well. 1-2 from Ajax Cape Town, a through ball attempt in the middle of the park, but Juanito couldn't get the pass right. The ball right. There seems to be a substitution for Ajax Cape Town that we didn't notice that took place at halftime. Lukfester is in the middle of a park. I'm gonna find out right now who he replaced. There has been a midfield change for Ajax Cape Town, because Lukfester, jersey number 17, is in the middle of a park, replaced.
Keep it there, Sammy.
I think he's replaced jersey number 10. Godfrey Persson, who got injured later on in a half. I'm not sure if it was a forced substitution from Ajax Cape Town through another injury. Remember, it's a very tight and fiercely contested middle of the park. So tackles are coming in fast and thick, and it's not a rough game by any imagination, but it's a very tightly contested game. It's one of those games, if you go on a 50-50, you're gonna get a very competitive opposition. Long ball from Crystal Palace, looping header from Ajax Cape Town goalkeeper Jacobs comes out, fetches it, quick delivery to Juanito. Well anticipated. Juanito still has the ball. He was fouled. Free kick from Fester. Changed his mind. He decided to leave it 14 Solomons. Ajax Cape Town is going to start from the back. Long build up to Dylan Franz. Dylan Franz has a good timing about him, but he's been adjudged to have pulled the jersey for the Ajax defender. It's been one of those afternoons where, you know, interesting back balls for JD Adams. He took risks, but I guess the young boy is very confident at the moment. Foul. So Nwabili has been brought down. So everything, and he had a very interesting first half. He's controlled or tried to make movement in the middle of a park. I'm very impressed by the positive build up from the Ajax youngsters. They seem to have taken a long stride and making sure that they impose themselves well into this game. You know, the movement seems impressive, the attack coming from both sides, and they've just won a corner. Juanito, you know, giving his best to make sure that he creates opportunities for his teammates. So it's first corner in the first half for Ajax Cape Town, in the second half for Ajax Cape Town, let's see what they're gonna do with the ball. Juanito taking the corner. Let's see who's he finding in there. Oh, nice clearance from Crystal Palace, the back. He took the ball right there in the head of Mohamed Bou. Just got a report from the Ajax management that it has been a knee injury that has forced the first half goalkeeper substitution, where Ronaldo Lena was substituted. He was really had a bad knee injury there. He felt the pain. He couldn't take it anymore. A nice reverse pass from Sonwabile. Gets a polar goal. A shot. Didn't take a shot. He passed it 1-2 with nicely dealt with by Crystal Palace. Crystal Palace, they defend in numbers and they work very hard, I must say. They look a very organized unit with all the effort put in by the Ajax players, and they seem to be able to deal with everything. But it's quite a very interesting information that we got there from the Ajax goalkeeper, and I hope he's not going to be out for long. But it's very I wish him all the best in the recovery with his knee injury. But he's got an able replacement, another substitution taking place at the moment for Crystal Palace. And jersey number 12 comes in, and the energetic jersey number 10, a player that I thought he had a very good game in Taylor Nwafaro, had a very good first half. He is coming off, and he's been replaced by jersey number 12, Lungile Mayekiso, who's replacing him. JD Adams is quite happy with the substitution, because he's going to get to breathe a bit, because he was taken a little bit into pieces by a very interesting number 10 from Crystal Palace. He had a very good first half, I guess he faded away a little bit in the second half. But we continue with the action. I Cape Town taking on the action into Crystal Palace. It's well contested ball in halfway through. Don't tell me it's going to be another misjudgment from Jacobs. No, it's not. He dealt with it very well. But he seems to be finding his feet now. You know, he's very vibey and energetic right around his box. Well-taken ball from the Ajax captain, Fredericks, is coming in. Are we going to see a through pass? Through pass from him. Juanito has the ball in the box. Cross! I think that was a bad choice there from Juanito. He could have crossed the ball across the goal line, you know, force the goalkeepers and the defenders to make mistakes. You know, but, you know, they're youngsters. They'll make the right decision on the right times. And it was a well attempt for him, but it went wide. Clearance from the Crystal Palace goalkeeper. Well dealt with by Dean Solomons, tightly marking the number nine. He's kept him quiet because earlier on in the game, the number nine seems to be giving him a lot of headaches, but he's been quiet at the moment. Nicely contested ball in the middle of a park by Luke Fester. He has the ball in the middle of the park. He looked, played long. Missed pass. Mayegi saw the new player on the ball for Crystal Palace. He played it wide. A well-timed cross from Crystal Palace. Over the bar. Goal kick. Crystal.
Guy, Bugle! Keep it here now!
We were talking earlier on about Luther Jacobs, who's come on in the second half, replacing Ronaldo Lehner. He's gone better, in actually, as the time goes. He's gone better and better. Dean Solomon has the ball. Passing to Sonobile. Sonobile plays it to Anele. Anele plays it to Juanito. 1-2 again. Intercepted by Crystal Palace. Battle in the middle of the field from Sonobile. Retaliation from the Crystal Palace players. I'm not too sure why. Samkelo Lumko. He might be in trouble with the referee. An unnecessary off the ball retaliation. It was completely unnecessary, but the referee seems to be a fair gentleman. He is talking to him. He's just giving him a word, talking to him. Should be a straight red card. Retaliation is not accepted in football, but the referee seems to have everything under control and he has let it go. I see Sam Gelo nodding. His coach there on the bench telling him not to do that again. Got away with it. Crystal Palace are still 11 men on the pitch. Should be 10 men, but you know, referee has the game under control. He's not trying to spoil the spirit of the game. Ajax Cape Town win the ball. They play through the right wing. Nice run from the Ajax Cape Town captain. He's pressuring on. He's putting pressure on the goalkeeper. Let's see what he's going to do. Almost nick it off. Almost nick it right in front of the goalkeeper. Trying to cross the ball wide. Dylan France dealt with it. Missed it. The Crystal Palace goalkeeper dealt with the little trouble from Ajax Cape Town. The game seems to have a lot of opportunities right now, with Luke Fester seems to be coming in and quality delivery intercepted by Crystal Palace. Another bad interception from Ajax Cape Town. They seem to be playing with danger in the middle of the goals. It's unbelievable. You think you get the ball in control. Luther Jacobs, the goalkeeper of Ajax Cape Town, throwing the ball right in the middle of the pitch, intercepted by Crystal Palace. Lucky for him, second time around, it came to nothing. Corner for Crystal Palace, given away by Crystal Palace. Best easy ball that was given to him. Let's see what Ajax Cape Town is going to do this ball. Courtney has the ball. Courtney has to choose. Short! Blocked by Crystal Palace. Crossover. The ball came to nothing. I think the bad decision made by Courtney Williams when he had players supporting him didn't do anything about it. Long ball from Ajax Cape Town, all the way played across. Cool, calm, and collected. from the Crystal Palace left back. Cool, calm and collected. We have seen calm decision from defenders of both sides tonight. They've made tackles that are normally made by quite matured players at the senior level, but they seem to be conducting themselves very well tonight. As I said earlier on, it's a well-contested game where both teams are showing their best, quality football being played, getting better minute by minute. As the second half is going ahead, you could see the class of the players now. You could see they've settled in. They know what is at stake. They know how to deal with dangerous balls. I'm very impressed with how they deal with long balls tonight. Both defenders of both teams tackled from behind from Crystal Palace again. And I think the referee is going to be talking another warning to the Crystal Palace player. Tackle from behind. A chat from the referee. It comes to nothing. Now I'm starting to believe that the referee didn't bring his yellow cards today because he hasn't been able to go in his pocket. When players are merited to be given a yellow card, nothing has happened. And 1-2 from Crystal Palace. I escaped on JD Adams, dealt with the ball. Another injury update from Ice Cape Town. MCL injury from Godfrey Preston. I did say earlier on he was substituted after a heavy tackle in the first half. He didn't make it in the second half. He was replaced by Luke Foster. And obviously that prompted a shift in midfield for Ajax Cape Town. So we've been told that Godfrey Preston has an MCL injury. And it's quite unfortunate because he was coming in the game very well, interplay in the middle of the park. He was creating opposition. He was actually making a nuisance of himself and creating a lot of headache for the opposition. Great pass from Dean Solomons. Well tackled. Well tackled by Crystal Palace and left the Ajax left back down. Quite interesting. It was a very good tackle. Azola. Jobo got the best of the hard tackle from Crystal Palace. It's going to be a long evening from these boys. That's the only way they can learn is to feel the battle from the opposition. There are no favours for them. Bad touch from Dylan French. It's a bad touch from him. He was trying to trap the ball down. You know, he had his ball back on his defender. Again, well-contested ball in the middle of the park. Luke Foster winning the ball. So Nabila got the ball. Juanito goes wide. He comes in. Decent pass in the middle of the park. Dylan French didn't read it. And the ball went all the way out. Another throw-in from Ajax Cape Town. It's been that kind of a second half where players are starting to make mistakes now. I guess fatigue is starting to creep in to some of the players on the field, but it's still a beautiful game. It's still nice movement from both teams. It's very competitive, and there's some goal scoring opportunities as well, but defenders are dealing very well with pressure. Both defenders. Luke Foster has the ball. What is he gonna do with it? He played a great ball to Azola. I'm sure we're gonna see a great cross from Ice header. Good improvisation from the Ajax captain. Frederick seems to know how to read the game well. But he missed an opportunity there. Ajax Cape Town built up again. Slow build up from Ajax Cape Town. Long looping run, looking for the run of Azola all the way from the left back. Dealt with very well by Crystal Palace. Crystal Palace, they're reading the game well. They know how to take the fire off the game. Juanita has the ball, running 1-2. Juanita. Goal kick. Goal kick. Final substitution for Crystal Palace. Jersey number 14 is going to come in. Anela Jalivane is coming on. Who is he replacing? Let's see who is he replacing. But Anela Jalivane is coming on. And he's replacing jersey number 8. Vuyani Nzolokohlo. He's been replaced by Anela Jalivane. Anela Jalivane, jersey number 14 in orange boots. He goes straight in the middle of a pack. Remember I said earlier on, it's a battle of the midfield. I think the game tonight, if there's ever going to be a winner, it's going to come from the middle of the pack. The winner will come from the middle of the pack. Now again another fiercely contested movement in the middle of the park. Ice kept on putting more players behind the goal. They're able to intercept or cut off any action from Crystal Palace. And it's been that kind of a game. But let me update you on what happened on the injuries today. A knee injury to Ajax goalkeeper, which I've updated you earlier on. It's been confirmed by the Ajax physios. Well, great news from the Ajax team on the medical report of the players that went out injured. They said everything seems to be under control. Brilliant work from our medical team. They have everything under control. The players would not be out for long. It's expected that by the time we go through the next game, those players will be available. The final change from Ajax Cape Town coming up. Final change for Ajax Cape Town. Jersey number 11, Orabile Marule is coming on, replacing. Replacing jersey number 7, Courtney Williams. We had a great game tonight, I must say. I guess he also one of those players that ran out of steam. It's been a great game from Courtney Williams. He had in the first half a lot of action. Cross from Crystal Palace, offside. Referee called it offside. It was a very impressive afternoon from Courtney Williams. And I know this young man that just came on now, he's got a very swift left foot. On his day, he can turn the game on his head. Let's see what he has tonight. He comes straight into the left wing. So a swap of wing play from Juanito going to the right and Orabile coming on the left. Long clearance from the Ajax goalkeeper. We expect a flick on from Dylan France. Ajax players collided. Sonabile, there he goes, Orabile again on the bicycle. 1-2 with Sonabile. Well dealt with by Crystal Palace. Yeah, Orabile. Yeah, wow. Maybe Orabile should have come in well warmed up after that miss with the ball right now. But we're still continuing with the action. Second half of this Ajax versus Crystal Palace game. Orabile on the ball, trying to find long ball, trying to find Dylan France. Well intercepted by the Crystal Palace defense. Another through ball in between. My word. Crystal Palace seems to be able to intercept in the middle of a park. I think the only way for Ajax Cape Town to break this Crystal Palace defense is to go wide and play quick crosses into the middle of the park when they're not expecting it. Nice control from the substitution from Crystal Palace. He knows how to play with the ball, but unfortunately the ball didn't reach his man. Orabile on the ball again. Long passes he's trying to get Dylan France. He's quickly in trying to get the ball to Dylan France. 21 minutes into the second half with 24 minutes left of the second half with the game between Ajax Cape Town and Crystal Palace. ABC Motsepe League. For those who don't know, Ajax Cape Town having the young lads with the average age of 17 competing against a very senior looking Crystal Palace team that came very prepared tonight. Very, very, very prepared. I must say they're very competitive and they're doing a great job in holding Ajax into this 1-1 scoreline in the 71st minute of the 76 minutes, I beg your pardon, of this second half.
Find your man there! Jumbo!
I'm not too sure what Luke Fester was looking for there. Maybe he was looking for the commentary box. He tried to hit a long diagonal pass to the commentary box. He would have reached that ball, I would have said, well done, my boy. but it didn't. Flick on header there from Crystal Palace. Ajax dealt with it. So Nalery goes up again. He's contesting very well in the air tonight. Luke Fester has the ball. Let's see who's he going to find. Long diagonal pass trying to find Juanito. Well matched by the Crystal Palace left back. What is he going to do with the ball? The ball out. No, not yet out. He's been able to keep it on. Well tacked there by the Ajax right back. JD Adams also had a good game. You know, there are a number of players that had a good game today. I did make mention of the substituted Crystal Palace jersey number 10, a youngster who I thought that impressed me the most today. He did his job right. And the referee is going to be talking to the Ajax captain on the infringement. It's an unnecessary tugging of shirts from the defender. But the referee, as I said earlier on, I don't think he brought his cards today. And I haven't seen him reaching his pocket. A long delivery ball from Crystal Palace reaches the Ajax keeper. Long clearance from the Ajax keeper looking for Juanito, the left back of Crystal Palace, is able to deal with the ball. So are we playing ping pong now? Yeah, it is. An exchange of ping pong passes to both goalkeepers. Yeah, well, I guess that's what happened, you know, in the game where you're not creating enough scoring chances. It's going to be a question of goalkeepers trying to find each other. They seem to have a comfort in distributing the ball both ways. Dylan France coming to battle up with the captain of Crystal Palace. Interception from Ajax captain. The captain has the ball. Fredericks, what does he do with the ball? He goes in, taking on one-on-one. Is he fine? Orabile, cross from Orabile. No, he comes in. Back to the captain. 1-2 with Ajax captain. Oh, my word. Oh, my word. Yeah. It's going to be a long evening. It's going to be a long evening. After all the hard work done by Ajax Cape Town captain Fredericks, 1-2 with Orabile into the D-line. A shot. Didn't match the action. Didn't match the action at all. Go along with the action. Jacobs clears the ball from the Ajax goalkeeper at the back. Dylan France goes up, trying to win the ball 50-50. It's been judged to have infringed the Crystal Palace left back. Crystal Palace take the ball in the middle of the park. We're trying to build, small build up from Crystal Palace. Long ball, again, it seems to be the order of the day. Well, I don't blame them. They got a very competitive number nine who's able to deal with every ball that comes in the air. But Ajax Cape Town also equally as competitive in being able to match the number nine. He's not been given too much room. I guess that's the nature of this game. Everybody has his match and they're able to deal with whatever comes there. 1-2 for Crystal Palace. Is he going to get the... No, dealt with very well by Ajax Cape Town. Cleared the ball for throwing. 26 minutes into the second half on it. Just about 20 minutes left if you would add the referee's optional time. There's very few injuries in between. I don't think there's going to be a lot of injury time added into this game. Again, another well-timed tackle from the Ajax midfielder. So Noamide on the ball again. And not the smartest pass from Oramide. Well-worked ball from Sonabin again. He uses his reaches very well and his long legs. He's able to get to the ball. Another one to Sonabin. Well-timed again from the Crystal Palace. Sheldon Barnes. Well tackled. He left Sonabin on the floor. And I guess it's just one of those games where the tackles are coming in thick and fast and everybody's able to contest for the ball in any way they can. But I have been impressed by the Crystal Palace captain, Sheldon Barnes. He's dealt with everything. Again, he comes up on top. With Crystal Palace, here comes Crystal Palace coming up wide. Where's the cross? Genuine cross! The goalkeeper dealt with it. Goalkeeper dealt with it. Well done to the Ajax goalkeepers. Let's see what does he do with the ball. Long clearance from Ajax Cape Town. Finding Juanito. Juanito flip on the ball back to Dylan French, the captain of Ajax. It has the ball. 1-2 with Sonabile. What happens to the ball now? Long diagonal pass from Sonabile. Doesn't reach the Ajax. Orabile. The captain has the ball. Goalkeeper. Every now and again, we do see some interesting interpasses from the Ajax team, but they're not able to finish it off. I'm not so sure whether is it the rush of blood or is the consistency doesn't get there yet? They're not maybe finding the right combinations yet. Pressured by Crystal Palace, and I must say, Crystal Palace have been able to come to the party in terms of being able to compete with these Ajax youngsters. You know, free kick to Ajax Cape Town, taken on quickly by Juanito. Sonabile on the ball. The Ajax captain is still down. Sonabile with the long cross, trying to find Frenchman. Crystal Palace again dealt with it well. Crystal Palace have the ball wide. And they're coming to Ajax, attacking fast. Counter attack from Crystal Palace. 1-2 pass in the middle of a park. Another 1-2. Good 1-2 from Crystal Palace. They're going backwards. Cross from Crystal Palace. Tame shot. Dealt with well by Ajax goalkeeper, who distribute the ball to Orabide here, right here, left wide. What is he going to do with the ball? He finds Luke Fester. Luke Fester, bad touch from Luke Fester. It looks like a dangerous move. Ajax caught one on one. Crystal Palace 1-2. Another bad pass. Another bad pass. It's that kind of an evening where we find loose passes going to the wrong. What a move there from the Ajax left back. Another back pass again. Seems to be the order of the day. Azola with a great move. Great move from him. Azola again working it out in the head with Dean Solomons, winning the ball in the head. Juanito, what is he going to do? He has the ball. He looks up, finds the captain again. Fredericks. Fredericks on the ball. Who is he going to look for? He looks for Juanito. Juanito takes on the Crystal Palace left back cross. Dealt with by Crystal Palace. Dealt with by Crystal Palace. It seems as if the two teams are able to match each other in every move. It's quite a very interesting matchup. But the captain of Ajax Cape Town has the ball right now. What is he going to do? He tried to find the Ajax right back, JD Willie Adams. To no avail, the ball went out. Another throw in from Ajax Cape Town. Another throw in for Ajax Cape Town. It's still 1-1 here in Pero Tikamva. Crystal Palace, the visitors, they're taking on Ajax Cape Town. It's 1-1. The goals came on very early on in the first half of the game. Both blunders by both goalkeepers resulted in both strikers of both teams taking advantage of the mistake made by the two goalkeepers. But we're back in action now. Ajax Cape Town has the ball. What is Orabile going to do with the ball? He takes on his 1-2 with Sonwabile. There he goes. Ajax go wide. Another 1-2 again. We're expecting a cross. Juanito has the ball in the middle. He drops it down to Sonwabile. Well defended by Crystal Palace once more. 1-2 from Ajax Cape Town. The captain has the ball. What is he going to do? He tries to find Sonwabile. Juanito has the ball. Cross, right wing. Crossover. Excellent, Kwepali. That was a very close, a very interesting 1-2 from Ajax Cape Town, with Juanito hitting a cross shot across the goalpost. It looks like we're heading into the final part of the game. It's 31 minutes in the second half. 31 minutes in the second half, 14 minutes to go. And it's still 1-1 with both teams cancelling each other's moves, matching each other in most departments. In the second half, with Ajax Cape Town tipping the chances created in the game. And still, we're back. 1-1. Franch has the ball. Play with Sonwabile. 1-2. Juanito has the ball. What is he going to do? Sonwabile has been tackled down by the Crystal Palace midfield. The referee didn't see it. We're expecting a free kick goes. The referee points it for Crystal Palace. He's taken quickly. The Crystal Palace left back played wide to the Crystal Palace left wing. Well worn by JD Adams. He plays a quick move while the Crystal Palace right wing is down on the ground. Seems to be infringed by JD Adams while they were tussling for the ball. I think he hit him with the elbow on his face, but that's what he claims. We never know. But the referee didn't see that. That's why he didn't call it. He gave the free kick to Ajax Cape Town. JD Adams won the free kick. He wanted to play the ball quickly, but the referee stopped the game. So we start back live, moving quickly. Ajax Cape Town play the ball to Luke Fester. Luke Fester has a ball to Azola. Zola played one Orabile. Orabile has the ball in the middle of the park. Center half, he plays a neat pass. That's the Azola is going to get the ball. The captain doesn't see him, doesn't take that option. He goes wide, cross. Dealt with Crystal Palace once again. I don't know for how long will Crystal Palace be able to deal with this pressure from Ajax Cape Town. It seems to be mounting now. Azola has the ball from left back, overlapping nicely. Well-timed cross played to try to find French. Dealt with by Crystal Palace once again.
Aita, come on!
Didn't France seems to be moving in tight spots in the second half? He can't find space. The Crystal Palace defender seems to deal with him all the time. We're expecting, there's Crystal Palace coming, attacking. 1-2. What a save! What a save by the Ajax goalkeeper. With his feet, brilliant move from Crystal Palace. I did say the Lungile Mayekiso, who came on as a second half substitution for Crystal Palace, seems to be very, very good on his feet. He seems to be finding the pockets in the midfield. Very dangerous coming in the middle. Play 1-2 with the striker. Brilliant save by the Ajax goalkeeper. Corner for Crystal Palace, dealt with by Ajax Cape Town. Nice clearance from Ajax Cape Town. It goes to Lungile Mayekiso again. He has the ball. He's very comfortable on the ball. Cross from him. Chest from the Crystal Palace striker. Ajax Cape Town dealt with it. Short! White came to nothing. Came to nothing. Two shots at Crystal Palace. Well saved from the Ajax goalkeeper Jacobs. He redeemed himself well in the second half. He showed his true class, and he was there for Ajax Cape Town when it was needed. Nice battle between Orabile and the Crystal Palace left back. Oh, the referee do have the yellow card in his pocket. Oh, it took him 70. Well, it took him almost 18 minutes of the game. It took him almost 18 minutes of the game before he could issue his first yellow card. It went on to the Crystal Palace right back for tagging of shirt of Orabile, the Ajax Cape Town left wing. So the first yellow card of the game. I guess the referee has been patient enough, lenient, trying to let the flow, trying to get the goal, game going. Ajax Cape Town dealt with a beautiful floated ball with the Crystal Palace goalkeeper dealing with the cross that came his way. But I think he went on to deal with the Ajax defender, who was still down, needed some attention. But it's getting up. It's getting up. It was Mohamed Bull who went all the way up for the free kick, tried to read the ball that came his way. He dealt with it well. Long ball from the Crystal Palace keeper, couldn't reach the Crystal Palace left wing.
Hey, stay switched on!
Well, I must say, I actually forgot about the cold that we're experiencing here in Peru, because the game did heat up and some interesting action tonight, and it makes you forget about the cold. I must compliment our production team. They did bring me coffee earlier on, you know, to warm me up in this cold evening. Nicely made cappuccino from the Ajax cafeteria. Yes, if you're watching the Ajax games here at Tikamva, you will get the lovely made coffee. It comes with nicely saved biscuits. Melo always like to make sure that I get extra biscuits whenever he has his coffee. It's quite an interesting night. You can also get yourself a supper, because they do make nice meals, nice burgers, a meal of the night. So you would not starve yourself at all. They do take care of all the visitors here. The Crefie calls for play on. The Crystal Palace players were calling for handball right in front of the Ajax goal line. Let every wave play on. Crystal Palace now are attacking. Poor shot from the Crystal Palace. And don't forget, tomorrow Ajax Cape Town PSL team, the Ajax Cape Town, the Urban Warriors, will be heading to Mbekweni Power, where they will be playing against Mbekweni 11, which is the PAL selected team. you know, supporting your community by bringing the professional team to the community. IFK Cape Town's initiative to be able to reach out to their fans. At 2 o'clock kickoff, that will be there in Pal tomorrow. Orabile has the ball back to action. Orabile is going wide. He's been chased by three Crystal Palace defenders, but he's been able to deal with them. He has the ball wide, plays to Azon. No, he plays the dummy there. Frederick has the ball for IFK Cape Town. Well tackled by Crystal Palace. Crystal Palace has the ball. Move in the middle of the park. I thought that was a dive. The yellow card comes up. Yellow card comes up. Mohamed Boul has been yellow carded. In my book, that was a dive. It was a dive, but the Crystal Palace, the midfielder, managed to fool the referee, and the referee bought it. Yellow card for IFK Cape Town. It's one apiece in terms of yellow cards. Crystal Palace has a ball, playing it wide. At the last stages of this game, you could see the players actually starting to make a lot of mistakes now, but there's gaps in the midfield for IFK Cape Town. Another 1-2 from Crystal Palace. A referee saw handball. It's been attacked by the referee.
Pick up!
We are in the 39th minute of the second half. IFK Cape Town take on Crystal Palace in the ABC Motsepe match. Started this evening at 7 o'clock here at Tikamva. Well contested game. It's been a very trouble-free match. It's a lot of good action in between players. Well contested match in the middle of the park. Luke Fester again. He comes up with a great tackle, but the referee are charging to have fouled the Crystal Palace players. Free kick, 35 yards into the IS goals. Let's see what the Crystal Palace midfielders are going to do with it. They're trying to take a quick free kick. Didn't work. The referee saw it. He was trying to call the defensive wall for IS Cape Town, so he asked the players to wait for his whistle. There he goes, he's counting to 10 and trying to put the IX wall. We draw his mark. He didn't bring his magic spray today, so I guess we're not going to have the magic line. The Crystal Palace player on the ball. It's the number 14 with the orange boots. Shot blocked by the IX wall. And the action continues. The Crystal Palace players are coming in. They're coming in thick and fast, and they're trying to penetrate to the byline. Dealt with by IFK Cape Town once again. A throw in from Crystal Palace is fine. The jersey number 14, Samgelo. What is he going to do with the ball? Cross. Dealt with by IFK Cape Town. Sonobile has the ball. Trying to clear the ball. Blocked by Crystal Palace. The ball is still on play. JD Adams dealt with the ball, played wide. Crystal Palace are getting confidence at the moment. They're throwing in balls in the middle park. Azola dealt with again, but still landed on the feet of the Crystal Palace midfielder. What is Dylan France going to do with the ball? He traps it. Well done from him. He put it down, but he gave it away once again. Crystal Palace is coming in, and they're coming thick and fast with his attack. Long ball across ball. I find the Ajax left-back Azola with the ball. He's chasing. Well cleared. He's trying to find his captain. His captain is one-on-one with the Crystal Palace defenders. He has the ball. So Nabil has the ball. Pass it to Orabile. Orabile coming out wide. Cross from Orabile. A beautiful cross. Is he going to reach? France got the ball. What happened? Ajax attack. Infringement. The referee calls it infringement. Another yellow card from Ajax Cape Town. Sonabile has been seen to have blocked the Crystal Palace goalkeeper from taking the free kick quickly. He's been yellow carded for that. It's two yellow cards for Ajax Cape Town. One yellow card from Crystal Palace. Delay tactics from Sonabile, who blocked the goalkeeper of Crystal Palace from taking a quick free kick, which prevented Crystal Palace from counter-attacking Ajax Cape Town. Ajax Cape Town trying to attack. Dylan France, he felt he was being infringed by the Crystal Palace defense. Offside called by Ajax Cape Town. Quick ball for Orabile is coming up wide on the left. He has a ball. He played it quickly to his captain. His captain is going the byline. One on one, captain on captain. He has a ball. Orabile comes in. Shot from Ajax Cape Town. Whoa. Orabile. or Robinho in front of the Crystal Palace goalkeeper. He could only find wide. Mohamed Bouly has to be careful. He threw the ball away where he knows he is yellow carded. The referee could have given him a second yellow card there, and he would have been seeing the back of the referee's books. But he got lucky there. The referee was very lenient. Ajax Cape Town attacking again from wide. But I mean, he's seeing the ball a lot. He's making decent runs, but he doesn't know how to deal with the final ball. You know, with the last chance that he got, probably the best chance of the whole evening, he was right there in front with the goalkeeper, short wide with another free kick given away by Ajax Cape Town. Tackle from behind, another yellow card from Ajax Cape Town. The Ajax players have lost their head at the moment. They giving away silly fouls, retaliating, getting unnecessary yellow cards. It's 1 minute, final minute of the game. I'm not too sure how much referee's optional time is gonna be, but Luke Fester has won the ball in the middle of the park for Ajax Cape Town. Jonito has won the ball in the middle of the field. Dylan French starts to deal with Jonito, has the ball again, is coming up wide, contested by two defenders from Crystal Palace. Crystal Palace have won the ball, played it wide to a very bully number nine striker who's lost the ball to the Ajax Cape Town. Mohamed Bouly headed it back to his goalkeeper. His goalkeeper, Luke Jacobs, throws the ball straight into JD Adams, trying to play the ball quickly to Bevan Dylan French. Dylan French, who didn't get the pass. Crystal Palace has the ball. They are taking right now. Whoever gets closer to the ball, he tries to attack and get into goals, will probably score a winning goal. Orabile got the ball, lost it in the middle of the park. What a pass to the captain. Side kick from Luke Fester. The captain gets the ball in the byline. One-on-one with the opposition captain. Another 1-2 between the Ajax captain, Fredericks. Cross from him. Middle of the cross. Orabile has the ball in the box. Shot! Juanito! Blocked by Crystal Palace. Samkelo has a ball and been well tackled by Ajax Cape Town. Luke Fester has made interesting tackles since he came on in the second half. He has won more balls in the middle of the park since he came on in the last 45 minutes. I guess, you know, that's what happened when you talk about substitution. People that come in and make impact in the game and make a difference in the middle of the park. Dylan Franz has a ball for Ajax Cape Town. Cross from Ajax Cape Town. Header! Some get a tackle from Crystal Palace. Crystal Palace are able to deal with whatever has been thrown by Ajax Cape Town. Dean Solomons has the ball. JD Adams has the ball at right back. Frenchman has the ball again. He's trying to deceive the Crystal Palace defense, but they dealt well with him. Luke Fester dealing with the ball, crossed by JD Adams, trying to find Samkelo right there in the middle of the park. Samkelo missed the ball so normally, by the way. He missed the cross. Azola has the ball at left back, throws it to Dean Solomon. Dean Solomon tries to keep it. Luke Fester has been attacked by two Crystal Palace midfielders. He dealt well with them. He still has the ball. Free kick. Free kick. The referee called it free kick. Luke Fester, he was late in tackling the Crystal Palace right back. I think the referee is going to talk to Luke Fester. He's looking for him. Oh, he didn't. He didn't deal with him. We are in referee's optional time. 1 minute of the referee's optional time has surpassed. Cross from Crystal Palace, dealt with brilliantly by Ajax Cape Town. Ajax Cape Town has the ball, and the captain, he still has the energy, the Fredericks boy. He seems to have the upper hand in whenever he has the ball. A referee calls it. Calls it once. Twice. That's the end of the evening. It's the final score for Ajax Cape Town. It's 1-1. Ajax Cape Town 1. Crystal Palace 1. It's been a very interesting evening with the energies of the players boiling up, but it's been a well-contested game. I guess the 1-1 scoreline is a deserving result for teams that put in their best in tonight's game. IX Cape Town did their best to try to win the game. Crystal Palace did their best to try to win the game, but it wasn't to be. For all of those who came in to watch the game, thank you very much. I think it was a very nicely contested game between the two teams, and I hope to see many more of these fans that are supporting these two teams. Both teams played well tonight. For all of us here at Ikamva in Pedro Park, it's good night. Well done to both coaches, Stanton Weir and Herridge, with a nice display from their youngsters. It's good night. Gracias.